Glenn DeSimone, CEO, Curatio Life Sciences. That's Curatio Life Sciences. Glenn,
Yes,
please take
that's
it away.
Curatio. Thank you so much. We're Curatio Life Sciences, and I'm just I apologize here. Let me get shoot. Okay, thank you so much. We're very excited to be here. We're Curatio Life Sciences, full spectrum medical grade CBD. We believe we're the Tesla of the CBD market for three reasons. It's because we have breakthrough technology to improve performance and efficacy of our product. We have pharmaceutical grade standards that we practice throughout all manufacturing, and we're committed to innovation and future products. We obviously have a flooded market, a lot of misinformation, and a lot of me-too products, and an inability to make hard claims to differentiate. And that's why we put so much money into the R&D and development to truly create a unique product and separate ourselves from the rest. In addition to that, we have a topical line that was recently approved for OTC, so we're excited that we can actually make a pain claim. There's been major progress with our distribution. Our proposal is to raise $1.25 million by issuing convertible notes. $1 million of this will be for our base plan expenses, while $250,000 will be for the test market. Notes will be offered in $250,000 segments, paying 7% interest. Opportunity to convert notes to equity at 20% discount evaluation. We'll determine this at the third quarter of 2021. I'm about to get into why this is a good investment for you, but first I'd like to take you through our team, our superior product, our financial projections, our support programs, conversion to equity, and then the special initiative, which we're very excited about. Our leadership team is essentially myself, the CEO and founder, Glenn DeSimone, and my father, Glenn DeSimone. Both of us come from the healthcare industry and advertising. We've collectively have launched over 30 brands to commercial markets and have had over 40 years of experience. This is our vetted chain. This is our vetted supply chain, which is a critical part of our team. As you can see, everything is GMP certified throughout, FDA fulfilled, and going all the way through our media to our direct sales team. We have a growing distribution network, which we're very excited about. We were recently just taken on by Threshold Distributors, which has 11,000 natural food stores. OptiSource was a recent, we're being onboarded currently. They have 3,000 pharmacies and small pharmacy chains. There's many others, including Brazil. We have business in Brazil that we're very excited about. Now getting into the product. Curatio's engine is a fine-tuned ratio of cannabinoids, which has 85% CBD and 15% secondaries, the only brand that has this kind of secondary on the market that we're aware of. THC in our hemp is converted via patent-pending process to CBN, providing THC full-spectrum entourage effect. As you may or may not know, CBN also binds to the CB1 receptor, and with that, in combination with our full profile of hemp-derived terpenes, flavonoids, esters, proteins and fatty acids, it creates what we believe to be one of the most potent products on the market. The next issue is, of course, getting it into the body, and that's why we have a pharmaceutical grade delivery system. It's a state-of-the-art nanosonication technology that miniaturizes the droplet to 10 nanometers, which is actually the size of a DNA strand. Our nano CBD is encapsulated in a natural surfactant, very important there, increasing bioavailability compared to those that use polyencapsulations, greatly increasing absorption by 10 times, rapid onset, and extended duration of use. The delivery matters. Most CBD oils exhibit only 6 to 8% absorption. Most nanoemulsions increase up to 40% absorption. That's the polys I was referring to. Curatio increases absorption to 70%. Pharmaceutical grade standards are the pillars of our company. We're GMP certified throughout all of our manufacturing processes. We test our product three times, first at the initial ingredient, then at the nano processing stage, and then at the finished ingredient, finished product, I should say. We have COAs available for every product, available on a QR code on our box when the customer is aisle shopping. Here's our COA. It shows you exactly what is in our active ingredient and what is not. Our products are here. This here is our line of products that we're very proud of. We have our oral products on the left, which is our nano drops. They're available in 500 milligram regular strength, 1,000 milligram extra strength, available in regular flavor and in mint. And we have a spray as well, which is very convenient for travel. And on the right-hand side, we have our topical products, which range from a salve, a roll-on, and a cream, available in regular and extra strength. And in addition to our active ingredient and emulsion, this also contains clinical doses of comfrey, menthol, arnica, frankincense, and other essential oils, making it extremely powerful, rapid onset, duration of action, and of course, we can make the pain claim as well. I'm going to pass this over to Senior here.
Hi there. I'll take you through the financials. We have 4 years here of revenue projections that start at 2.8 next year, moving up to 22.8 million in the fourth year. Not even the percentage of market is 0.7% of that total market, which we think is going to be somewhere in the $3 to $4 billion range. Our expenses are down at the bottom, and we get to an EBITDA of 30% in the third year, which we think is quite positive. The cash flow analysis we've executed shows that at the middle of next year, we'll be at a deficit of $576,000 without the test market. With the test market expense, as you can see there, it'll be $826,000 at mid-year, and then it starts to fall off and it gets a little bit better through the rest of the year. The promotional program that supports Curatio is going to be two direct selling teams, a comprehensive direct marketing and advertising program that includes Facebook advertising, lead generation funnels, CRM system, collecting customer emails. We're getting 3,000 emails per month right now and growing at a 41-cent customer acquisition. We have 75 influencers from elite athletes to HCPs that reach an audience of 10 million followers. The Yankee chiropractor is a supporter of our product, by the way. And then we want to engage a public relations agency to be our partner. We said we had convertible notes. Let me take you through the conversion. We didn't get into that earlier on, but we were looking for $1.25 million. We think by the third quarter of next year, we can figure an accurate valuation for our company. We're saying we'll use the lower value of $5 million, which discounted at 20% at $4 million, gives the $1.25 million investment 31.25% of our company. We own 100,000 shares. So each segment, if on an investing basis, $250,000 would get 6.25% share of the company. As we look out into the future, at our projections year four, we're looking at about $20-25 million almost. And we think that that projected value of our company could be $100 million, which on an exit would be 2.5 to 3 times your initial investment. Okay, so that's our main deal. I want to now spend a couple of minutes on a stretch initiative. If you look at measured media in this category.
Glenn, you have 6 minutes, by the way, if you want to welcome questions.
Good, that's good. So you mean
no, including questions.
Including questions. I'm going to take a minute on this. Only $1 million is in measured media in 2009. It's basically newspapers and magazines, nothing in major broadcasts. So we're thinking of test marketing a broadcast media effort that will include CTV, radio, and podcast. The test cells we've selected would be Portland and Denver, which are high CDI areas, and Cleveland, which is a low CDI, just to see what kind of impact we would get from spending $250,000 total in those three cells to see what our ROI would be and what the upside growth potential is. This is a little bit of our national advertising campaign. We would take that and put it into the cells. These are the number of impressions that we get. And this is what the stretch would get us. We believe $30 million after 3 years of revenue, whereas the base plan gets us to 11. So for the cumulative ad spend of $7.5 million over the 3 years, which by the way, is not in our budget. This is another issue. We would gain $20 million of incremental revenue. So it's one invested dollar gets you three ROI. So it's an interesting thing that we're looking at. That's it.
Questions, panelists? Terry, would you like to take a shot at that? How about Josh?
Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm on mute.
No worries. Sorry.
I was just wondering, what is your profit margin in the two products that you have available?
Profit margin essentially depends on where we're selling it. If it's selling online, we're at about 6 times. If we're selling to wholesale, we're at 3 times. Distribution under the harshest terms where we're taking a lot of cuts, we're at least 2 times.
Okay. And on the convertible note that you have, is there a maturity on that? And also, can the investor actually opt to convert or just be paid out?
He could do either. We would like him to convert, but he could do either. Cool. And there would be probably a two-year maturity on the note.
Right. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Jeff?
Yeah, just a question about marketing. And obviously there's probably 1,000, maybe more CBD brands out there right now in the marketplace, and some pretty big ones like Charlotte's Web, obviously. And so just kind of curious what your marketing plan is on how to kind of cut through all the noise and all of that. And you know, is there a reason why none of the big guys are doing this kind of the media approach that you talked about in your stretch idea?
Yeah, so to answer your question, the media issue, why other brands aren't doing it, perhaps it's because of a risk. We plan on launching a national plan with our topical products, not with our oral products. We believe we're safe in doing that. But as far as our digital plan, that's really, our digital base plan is really what's going to set us apart from the rest, because of the funnels that we've developed with Facebook, Google Words, Microsoft Words, Bing. I mean, we've really figured out how to work these medias, because it's very tricky with as many brands as there are, and you pointed that out. So we believe that we're actually gaining an edge, and we're starting a momentum that will take us in this direction. What we're really looking for is the financing. We've already started this media plan, and it's starting to show success. So we believe with the proper finances, we'll be able to continue with this trajectory to cut through those thousands of brands.
Okay. We have 2 minutes left. Lindsay, do you have any questions? Or do you have a question?
Yeah, I thought I saw Brazil listed as a potential future market. What are your international plans, if any?
So currently we have business in Brazil. Curatio Life Sciences has Curatio CBD, which is the brand we're talking about right now. We also have an active ingredient. We have a company that we develop unique active ingredients. And we have a deal set up right now where we're providing Curatio to a network of doctors in Brazil, and we're being recommended. We've just been received by a network of 10,000 doctors in Brazil. And as you know, they're prescribing it very differently than they are over here. Doctors are very excited about the efficacy of the product, and they're thrilled about ours because of how strong it is. There's no THC, but our ratio has an entourage effect that's highly efficacious. So we're already doing business there. We're seeing it climb on a monthly basis, and we expect also that our raw material will continue to flow because pharmacies are now purchasing it. And we're working on a deal for 100 kilos per month to sell to Brazil. So we have a lot of things that are happening right now. It's really just a matter of getting finances to continue this trajectory.